All right, man, I'm kind of feeling like Santa Claus because week after week on Inside the Five, I continue to bring you top quality guests. And look who we've got here wearing his Golden State Warriors cap. Patrick Willis, number 52, has joined us. P. Willie, what's up, man?
Man, bro, hey, man, I appreciate the introduction, man. It made me feel pretty good, like I run out the tunnel again. I'm doing well, man. Doing well, bro. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Hey, what do you miss most about the game?
Well, I mean, it's probably, it'd be the teammates, man. The teammates, just a preparation, just each week, week in and week out. We grew together, and so it was just a lot of fun being out there with those guys.
Years ago, I was interviewing Ken Norton Jr., who played your position when he was with the 49ers. I asked him, hey, man, what do you miss most? You know what he said?
What's that?
Those game checks.
Oh, man. Hey, you know what? Hey, they were nice. I won't complain too much about those.
Alex Smith, getting into a game last week, that was one of the best things I saw coming out. You were a teammate of his. If you could just share with us his toughness and what got him through it, going in a situation where he almost lost that leg.
Yeah, man. Just to see Alex step back out there was truly remarkable. I mean, first off, I would say to Alex, you know, much respect to him, just him as an athlete, and just over the years competing with him and playing with him. I never forget, we was in off-season condition, and I think it was my second year. Because I think by then, you know, I could joke with the guys who had been on the team a little longer than I have. And we was outside doing off-season conditioning. And I remember we was running, and I'm thinking, like, you know, Alex, a quarterback, you know, he's not going to really get in. They pre-Madonnas. And, man, next thing I know, we was doing, like, quarter mile. I don't know if it was, like, the miles, but to track around the whole field, walk, run. I mean, and I never forget, we was going. And he took off, and I was like, man, Alex, you going? I started running harder, and I was like, he started running harder, and I was like, man, you got a little fight in you. But the biggest thing what I'm getting at is that he competed with us all the way around the whole field as a quarterback, and just seeing him compete like that when, you know, quarterbacks don't really have to, but just seeing him with that kind of fight meant a lot. And then just seeing what he had been through with injuries and then seeing him come back from those and then just all the stuff he's been through, man, he's a man built beyond. And so I'm just happy to see him doing what it is that he enjoys doing.
Patrick Willis joins us thanks to Joanne Pasternak Productions. And as I say that, I've got my Dwight Clark mask, and this is where I'm going because we got a little campaign going on, a little challenge going, 49-49, and we're in the midst of it all. All these teams are trying to catch Joe Montana's team, which has been in position one. I know you got a team in pursuit of trying to get people outside, 49 miles, 49 days. How's it going with your team?
So far, we're doing well. I mean, we started out really strong. We kind of dropped a little bit, but I'm really proud of everyone. Everyone is doing a great job. And just really the 49 and 49 fitness challenge, just in general, like you said, we're doing it for a great cause to give back to former 49 players who may need a helping hand in whatever way it may be, emotionally, mentally, and physically. And so just having fan support and just all you guys giving the love and support, I mean, it just really means a lot to us all. And so I say thank you to my teammates, to all the teams, you know, that are competing, to all the team captains. Just really appreciate everyone for being a part of this.
One more before we get out of here. When Mike Nolan's coaching staff was working with you guys, this was when you were getting ready for the Senior Bowl. Was there any inkling, any wink they gave you with a, hey, Patrick, you'll be playing with us on Sundays?
No, you know, I had none at all. I mean, matter of fact, they didn't even visit with me when I was down there. And then on top of that, I mean, having Coach Singletary as my linebacker coach, I never forget. And I love Coach Singletary to death and great respect for him. But I remember having him as my linebacker coach, and it felt like it was hell. It was hell that week. And I remember saying to myself, I was like, man, whatever happens, I do not want to go to San Fran and be coached by this man if this is how it's going to feel in practice. But lo and behold, the universe has something else in mind. And, you know, I was drafted to the 49ers, and I wouldn't have had any other way.
Well, you played it, and you played it well. There is a reason that there's no number 52 on that roster, because that number belongs to you.
Oh, Vern, man, I appreciate that. I appreciate that. And, again, just – looking back over my career, I thank everyone for the love, support, Vern, you guys, all the media, just appreciate you guys. It was a great ride, and 52 hopefully lives on for a long time. So
I got a little 52 in me, man. I'm gonna get in the air and give it my all. Yeah,
Let's go. I say every morning you wake up, man, put your best foot forward and then let the chips lay where they may.
It's what I do every day. Hey, go to goldenheartfund.org. Maybe you can get your own Dwight Clark mask.